Hi everyone and welcome to another video. Today's DIY is all about how to take your own maternity photos. As many of you know, I'm currently 36 weeks pregnant with my second baby. And with my first pregnancy, I didn't take any dedicated maternity photos. So this time around, this may be my last pregnancy. And so I really wanted to do some dedicated maternity photos so I could remember this time and my belly and just, you know, all the magic that pregnancy is. However, when I looked into getting professional photos done, I realized that they're actually super cost prohibitive. Most maternity photos are very expensive, and so I thought, oh, maybe I can just do my own. And I'm really happy and surprised with how they turned out. So I wanted to pass on some tips and some ideas to you so that you too could take your very own maternity photos, and I hope that they will come out just as good and you'll have them to look back on for years to come. So the three types of maternity photos I'm gonna show you today are, number one, the milk bath, which is like super popular right now, and for good reason. The photos look super, super cool. Number two, a traditional outdoor pregnancy shot, and I'll give you some tips for how to make that look more professional and come out really great. And the last one is the classic pregnancy silhouette. So without further ado, this is enough rambling. Let's jump into it and take some maternity photos. So the first thing I'm going to show you how to do is the milk bath photo shoot, and you'll want to start by removing any clutter from your bathtub and, of course, giving it a good wipe down. Now, when you prepare for your milk bath photo shoot, there's a couple of tips that I wanted to throw out there for you so that it'll come out the way that you want. The first being, you should run the water a little bit hotter than you intend to actually use, because it's going to cool down as you're decorating and, of course, when you put the milk in, especially if you're using real milk. Now, when you go to do this, you can use either just whole milk from the grocery store or even milk powder. I ended up using 2 gallons of whole milk because that was the most cost effective for me. It was the cheapest thing at our store. But really, you can go either way, and of course you're going to want to adjust the ratio based on how big your tub is, but what you're going for is to make the water so opaque that you can't see your skin if it's under the water. You can only see what's sticking out of it. So the first step in preparing the milk bath is to fill the tub with hot water. While you're waiting for the tub to fill, you can also start to decorate the perimeter of the tub. I use some greenery that I picked up at the grocery store, but you could also use flowers or really anything that you want to add some pop to the exterior of the tub. Then you'll want to slowly add in your milk. You can use a large whisk or a spoon to incorporate it into the water and make sure everything is blended really well. Now the last step is to add your flowers. So some of these I picked from my yard and some of them I got from just a cheap bouquet at Trader Joe's. And all you do is just cut the stems off of the flowers. So I have a bowl of just flower tops here and I'm going to spread them out throughout the tub. Yes, adore you all of the time. I like to So I really like the way this looks. Now I'm gonna go get ready and let's do some milk bath photos. So first we'll talk about wardrobe. You can really wear anything when you go to do these pictures, but I like the look of like the lacy or like more white clothes. So I just put on a white bra and underwear and then covered it with like a little floral like kimono thing. My husband and I had so much fun taking these pictures. He ended up like standing on a stool outside the tub so he could get above the bathtub and take some like looking down pictures. And then we took a few just from the side. And by the end of it, my daughter ended up climbing in with us. And I really liked the way those photos came out as well. So have fun with this. Play around with different angles. Look on Pinterest or Google Images and try to recreate ones that you like. And you can really have a good time doing these pictures. Now this is for all of you who would rather have an outdoor maternity photo. I have a few tips for how to make your DIY maternity pictures look a little more professional. The first of these being that you should only take outdoor photos in the early morning or late evening hours. Taking pictures outdoors at a time when the sun is lower and softer just gives your pictures a more professional look. You also might consider taking your outdoor photos on more of a cloudy day, as the clouds act like a buffer for the sun, filtering the light and giving your photos a softer feel. My last tip for taking outdoor photos is to always make sure that the sun is behind or at an angle to your subject. So if you're the subject, make sure you're not looking into the sun and squinting your face. It'll just cause shadows where you don't want them. So try to put the sun behind you or slightly beside you, and that'll help your pictures to look the way that you want. Now, the last DIY maternity photo I'm going to show you is quite possibly the easiest one to recreate, and that is the maternity silhouette. All you need for this picture is a window with a blind on it. So try to find a window that has good backlighting, and then just close the blind, and then all you're going to do is stand in front of it. Now you can see we're just taking most of these pictures with the iPhone. I actually use the iPhone to take almost all of these maternity pictures today, and that's because it is so easy to use. It has some great settings and the quality is actually really great. So if you don't have a fancy camera, don't limit yourself from taking maternity photos. They come out just as good on the phone. So we put the phone on the noir filter to do these pictures. You could also just leave it in the regular setting and then edit it later on your computer or on your phone, however you see fit. But we did the noir filter and then we zoomed in just so you could only see the window and the backlighting, and that just gave it a nice silhouette look to it. So I hope you enjoyed this DIY maternity photo video, and I hope that you'll put some of these ideas to the test. If you also have any suggestions to help people take better photos themselves, be sure to leave those in the comments below, and I will see you in the next one. Adios! I like to